Hi friends, welcome again. In this video we will talk about broad level of activities along with approximate timeline required for completion of an interior fit out project from scratch. This is how a raw interior fit out site looks like, which is basically building structure completed with glass facade. A typical commercial fit out raw site would resemble this picture almost 90% of the times globally. Mobilization of materials and resources takes the initial couple of days post the site kickoff meeting. Next important thing is the installation of all temporary services. This would include temporary electrical outlets, lights and water. This is important because without these you cannot run any tools, cannot work without the lights, and of course water is required for many construction related works, like masonry, PCC. Mobilization and installation of temporary services takes initial 3 to 4 days. After that, electrical and data raceways that will run in the flow and connect the modular furniture are marked. As per the markings done, electrical and data raceways are laid on floor. In parallel, the electrical conduits are also installed in ceiling. This takes around 7 to 10 days. Next is the preparation works done for floorscreed. Please note that the true flow slab has a very rough finish, so the cement screed is required to be laid on that. This gives a smooth surface and also helps in concealing the flow surfaces. Nearly around 50 to 75 millimeters is the thickness of screed, which varies as per the site condition. This will also have a 3 to 4 days of drying time, which can be further increased in winters or in humid weather. Next activity is the marking of the partitions. This basically involves marking for partitions, referring the marking layout drawing. Partition marking is followed by installation of these studs framework for partition. As a general practice, the center to center distance between the horizontal and vertical framing members is 600 mm. Once the framing is completed, single side gypsum boarding starts. This involves fixing gypsum board on one side of framing. Next, the partition internal services like electrical and data are planned, and accordingly conduits and raceways are installed in the partitions from the other side. In parallel, the conduits in ceiling for power and data are also installed. Once the conduit installation is completed in partitions, acoustic insulation is filled between the framing so that there are no cavities left. While all the works is happening, the HVAC and firefighting works are also going alongside. The prefabricated ducting is per the design is installed first. Next, nitrile rubber insulation is glued on it, which has two benefits, as it does not allows the cooling loss and also prevents from sweating on ducts due to condensation. Firefighting works involve running sprinkler pipes all over the ceiling and then installing sprinkler heads and finally testing the system for required pressure performance. This is mandatory requirement for getting the fire safety clearance. Once the partition insulation work is completed, partitions are closed with gypsum board from other side as well. Ceiling framing work is the next activity. This involves the installation of the ceiling framework, which is supported from the ceiling supports from the structural slab and from the sides of partition. The built-in furniture starts getting built alongside these works at site itself. After completion of ceiling framing works, the ceiling boarding is done by screwing gypsum boards to the frame. The partition and ceiling finishing works are the next activities. These involve jointing and taping of gypsum boards and is finished with a drywall compound followed by sanding. Once the smooth surface is achieved, primer coat is applied to take on the first layer of paint. The aluminum partition works installation is the next activity. This is basically the installation of framework, which will take on the glazing and doors of rooms or cabins. The finished gypsum ceiling is marked for lights, sprinklers, smoke detectors and other visible ceiling services, then the required size cutting is done to install them. The built-in furniture is finished in place along with final paint. The final finishing involves installation of fabrics, final paint, installation of modular furniture, installation of carpet or vinyl flooring. The site is finally cleaned and handed to client after doing a testing of all equipment and services. The time mentioned here is typical time, and this can vary greatly depending on site size and other constraints. Friends, thanks for your time in watching this video. I am looking forward for your comments, questions so that I can develop my upcoming videos accordingly. Please subscribe to my channel for getting regular updates on upcoming videos in the field of construction management and architecture.